All right, everybody, we are here today for a new special episode of Unculture. We have with us Hudson Alexander to discuss probably the most momentous day in rap so far this year. I think, album drop so far this year, I would definitely say.
I put it over J. Cole, yeah.
Yeah, it's been so weird. Maybe this just corresponds with me getting into it, but it's so weird to see a bunch of people who I feel like never gave Tyler the Creator time of day, all of a sudden really give him the time of day, and he's becoming like a cultural figure, like a status symbol of like, you gotta like him and kind of like be cool to like him. Like, he's one of the cool icons, I would say, of a lot of teenagers. Like, how did that happen? It's kind of crazy.
Well, he's definitely had a big, a huge turnaround, you know, but I think it started in Flower Boy, and then I think Igor kind of split, you know, people who liked Flower Boy, because not everyone liked what DJ Khaled would call mysterious shit. And so, like, kind of people were like, I don't know if I want to listen to Tyler or like want to, but you know, Igor's a good project. I mean, most people who appreciate music will appreciate Igor. But I think now that he's going a little bit back to rap, he's getting more mainstream, you know? So when he goes more mainstream and you add that with, you know, his creativity, it's like, it's bound to be one of the biggest albums of the year.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Like the mainstream nature, and but also doing the mainstream nature in a more creative, kind of like Tyler Creator way. And for example, the drama, the DJ drama aspect of it, like DJ drama is a very like specific sound known for elevating like specific artists kind of the mid-2000s era. And like, for example, all the way from Lil Uzi Vert to, I believe, like Lil Wayne and those people, he has been around and been a like very big pillar in a certain kind of rap. And you have Tyler the Creator coming in doing something that really does not sound like any kind of traditional like DJ drama. Like, DJ drama is much more of an accessory, but he's there kind of almost secondary when he wasn't in the past, but he still is bringing that flair, which I think speaks to also like the inventiveness. Like, you see very few artists completely do a completely different thing every album. Like, Kendrick Lamar is another example of these, but like Tyler the Creator completely changing it up. Like,
right, and Kanye. I think no one expected him to make a rap album. I don't think that was like what the expectation was for this album. Especially with like the little jingle that he's been like teasing it, like the call me, you lost. Like, I think people did not expect him to make a Gangster Grills tape with DJ Drama.
Well, if you had listened to Uncultured, we gave you the heads up on that in the last episode. But just saying, we had that covered.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't see that coming. I mean, I thought it probably would be a little more rap heavy, but you know, for the most part, I thought we'd probably be getting something similar to Igor. And we didn't. And I think it's a good thing that he's switching it up and not, so you don't know what to expect from him, you know?
Yeah, I personally love those kind of melodic parts of Tyler the Creator, because he does those so much better than I think anybody else, especially in the mainstream. Now, there's a bunch of people who do like melodic stuff that I like that are like less in the mainstream, but he's the most popular person who does that type of music. But still, a lot of stuff to like all throughout this album. And let's start with probably, I would say, when I started listening to this, I was a little bit sleepy, but it's the introduction. But still, a lot of good stuff in there for sure. This is Sir Baudelaire.
The sun beaming. Y'all ready? Ew. DJ the fuck. It's T-Baby. I don't think you're ready. Okay, you ready? Bunny Hop. I must say. Yo. I'm glad you found your way here. Yeah. Cookie crumbs in the rolls, jet fuel in a vest, swim trunks in a trunk, Geneva water the best, the passport looking thick, the afro need a pick, my skin soak up the sun, ain't shaking hands with you bums, bunny hopper, the new car doors they lift open, the lake water dry off with the French open, I rub it in these niggas faces like thick lotion, that big B is in motion, cool peach cobbler dough, spit like a llama dough, used to be reckless, you should see what them commas do, new the full season, summertime look like private school, keep it low, don't want that shit to blow like Osama's shoe, I'm a true connoisseur, hotel concierge, know me as that spaced out nigga with the chunky ears, UFC, that shit swole up, that's VVS, keep Vic safe, that's a mansion on that USB, it's T, yeah.
I hope you niggas been spending your time wisely,
call me if you get lost, baby,
as you can tell we have, this shit for the sun seekers,
this is Sir Baudelaire. You get Tyler the Creator, DJ Drama all over that kind of introduction track. And you hear that jingle. in the end. That was from those two videos that he released in the lead up that I think was actually very good and interesting. I like that rollout. That was pretty cool. You called the voicemail. Like that was very, very enjoyable. Probably not the best in terms of introductions, but
it's a short song, but it's a good intro. It's a classic intro. It's something Tyler would do. Mm-hmm. For sure.
Yeah, like at this point I wasn't like feeling too much about it, but before we go on, I just want to say like I do believe we kind of rushed past this. Where do you, because you know, it definitely changes like 3 days after an album's released, so maybe 3 weeks, 3 months, 3 years, you view it differently. But where do you now see this album fitting in the pantheon of Tyler the Creator's works?
Well, you know, I'm not a big fan of his earlier work. I'm just not a big fan of it. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I think my top two for his album are probably Flower Boy, and then Igor is probably number one, just because conceptually Igor is just a complete story and you can just listen to it from start to finish. But I did think, like, Igor is kind of better listened to, like, from start to finish. And, like, Flower Boy, I feel like you can jump around more and go back and forth. And when this album first came out, I was like, this is probably the rap equivalent of Flower Boy. But now that I've listened to him more, I think it's right on par with what he's of Igor. I think it's a great album. It doesn't miss on most songs. And I think the story that's being told can be listened to on a per song basis. It doesn't need to be listened to all the way through. I think there's like four or five songs that really really are part of the story, but they don't need, like, it doesn't need to be listened to. Like, you could just listen to Sweet and I Thought You Wanted to Dance, and you probably have a really good idea of what the story is already by the one song. So I just think that point and that element is on par with Igor. That's what I would say.
Yeah, I think, like, speaking of stories, that one song, Wiltshire, like, that's a song that I feel like if you're not ready to listen to it, almost you got to, like, skip it and then, like, come back to it. Because it feels so, if you're just sitting there listening, it's just droning on, you're not appreciating, like, what the song is fully. I kind of, like, listened to it, I was like, oh, my gosh. It was like, what happens next? It was, like, actually very, very compelling story about, like, oh, like, he meets a girl and the girl's dating somebody and then they go through, like, the kind of laughing relationships and, like, oh, hi, like, you know, getting, like, flirting pretty much right in front of the guy that she's dating. And then, oh, all of a sudden he realizes he gets jealous and gets mad and the relationship gets tense and fractured. And then they break up and they're just not the same anymore. Like, you don't have that same really impetus in the relationship. And that was such a fascinating dynamic because it just didn't go exactly in the way that you thought it would. I was like, wow, like, that to me is, like, on par with, like, Duckworth in terms of, like, a real interesting, like, comprehensive narrative that you never see in today's rap.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think the entire album, I'm just gonna pull up the list here. It's just perfect. I mean, I just have to say it's not what people thought, and I think for that reason it hits differently, and it's like, wow, he can do it whenever he wants. He can make whatever album, and it's going to sound good. He knows how to make himself sound good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that is definitely true. I think let's get, like, a little ranking system out of three. I would say, you know, good. You know, one is, like, pretty good, solid level. Two is, like, really good. And three is, like, amazing. Because I think that's probably all the fair places you can go in this album. I think we both agree on that. I'd say that was around a one for me personally. Where do you rank that before we go into our next
song?
Yeah, Sir Baudelaire.
Yeah, it's definitely one of the weaker songs, but it doesn't mean it's a bad song. It just,
yeah, that's what song is, yeah, that's what a one level. Is. Like, it's like, it's a low level for this album, but still it's a high level. All right.
Yeah.
Let's go to Corso here.
You call him Tyler Baudelaire. Look, I've been talking that fresh shit, I don't need gum. Cookie crumbs in the rolls, never know weed crumbs. He ain't talked to his bitch in 3 days. It ain't gotta be this way, I'm down for the threesome. I might buy a boat. Depends if Capri got space, don't really need one. I could go on the winter time, baby, I bleed some. Find another nigga like me, cause I ain't seen none.
pull up in that whatchamacallit. Played a couple demos at Madison Square Garden and tell them motherfuckers that Sony I'm not calling. I'm plotting on the Billy Chili in my garden. Yo.
Alright, I admit it. We just been playing with you niggas, man.
Hip-hop, French Waltz, she says she like the voice, and I'm like, which one? I got 200, look. Catch me at my other crib, that's my AKA. Hurricane proof, all the views, shit like A Bay Bay. If I just had ass, got passport, got tattoo, slim nigga, big dick, with a fucking gap tooth, the way he been. Call me Mr. Always, watch the shit you never seen. In that mansion, living single, bitch, I'm Maxine. Niggas are your standard, shouldn't talk. Give a fuck about your thoughts. Call me if you get lost, bitch.
Okay, now you understand what we came here to do, right? Oh, yeah, me, I got the name of DJ Drama. And on my side, that's Tyler Baudelaire, a.k.a. Buddy Hop, a.k.a. the creator. Call me if you get lost, suckers. We didn't come to play with you, nigga.
Tried to take somebody, bitch, cause I'm a bad person. I don't regress shit because that worth it. In the end, she picked him. I hope when they fuck in, she still thinking of me cause I'm that perfect. I'ma get that deep text when it's first surface. Better send it to my ego cause that shit hurting. Hope y'all shit working. I'm a psycho, high, don't give a fuck. You left my heart twerking, moving, losing. Grip on my doings, eyes is crying. On the jet cruising, about to spend millions just to fill voids up. Drama, I need you. Can you turn the noise up? Can you turn the noise up? Ah, nigga, my heart broken. Remember, I was rich, so I bought me some new emotions and a new boat, cause I'd rather cry in the ocean. It's tea, baby.
I tried to tell y'all.
I don't even like using the word bitch. It just sounded cool.
Y'all niggas know what's up.
Yeah, so that is Corsa. That is the second song there. Probably this is the one I really felt. Felt like the album like turned on for me. What was your reaction to it, Hudson?
Yeah, no, it's a great song. I think probably one. I mean, the production is unreal. I think it kind of set the tone for the album going forward, and the way he flows on is really good. I like the way he just kind of floats on the album on the song. Sorry, and I think it's just a good start. That's like I agree. It's a real one that kind of takes you into the album. That's like that he's building, creating. So it's definitely a good start.
Yeah, I think like that was definitely kind of a tone. It was very, very aggressive. It definitely sets the tone where you get the sense it's like this is a DJ Drama influence there. I think it does set the tone well. I think the one place where everyone was surprised, we're going to skip over Lemonhead for a little bit, but Young Boy Never Broke Again, coming on there, what was your reaction when you first heard that? Like, because I know there is the big thing of hating on a Young Boy, I think probably justifiably 99% of the time, but it really does look like Tyler did do an incredible thing for his career here.
Well, when the track list dropped, I actually thought it was fake because I was expecting something similar to Igor. So I was like,
42 this is Doug not and cool. YoungBoy NBA back to back is
yeah,
not,
like
not
I
would
have never believed you until I heard the songs. And so, you know, I really liked What's Your Name because he dropped a video before. It was just Tyler's part, though. So I had no idea it was coming up. I heard Ty Dolla Sign on it, but.
Yeah.
YoungBoy, he just does his, like, he just perfectly meshes with the song, and he doesn't try to do, like, what he's been doing with the rap. He just kind of joins Tyler in this kind of southern beat. It's kind of, it's kind of R&B kind of beat, and he nails it. So I think it's definitely one of the better features on the album, and it probably caught everyone by surprise.
It definitely did, yeah.
Working together, I never would have guessed if you paid me $1 million.
Yeah, that definitely caught a lot of people by surprise. And the features here were definitely something that made a lot of people surprised. What
I even knew Youngboy Preacher was there, and I still like forgot that he was on the song. Like,
yeah, it doesn't like, sound no like him. You're like, wait a minute, what? Like, you gotta go back because it didn't sound like this to me speaks to the crime that is what producers are doing to artists nowadays. Like, for example, DaBaby is another one people have been talking about, where oh, he has these like really weird disjointed beats that don't make any sense, and he raps like so well, so powerfully over them, and it's like, what could someone like DaBaby or I think. I saw this point made elsewhere as well. Megan Thee Stallion, like if she got a beat, like she could make a level. It's not like she could be a real icon in the female rap space. I definitely believe that. And just like the mainstream producers today, do you agree with me, Hudson, that they're just absolutely failing a lot of these artists?
I just don't think they have the talent to make beats as well, like as what you kind of want them to be on. I think. They're not caught up with the times.
I
think. The beats they make are really good, but I think like Kanye West, Tyler the Creator, Pharrell Williams, like these are artists who make amazing, unique beats. Yeah, I'm sure I'm forgetting some, but like they make some amazing beats.
There's a handful of people there that are really good. Yeah,
that are just unique, and I think a lot of artists could benefit from being on them. You know. But unfortunately, I don't think they don't get a chance because, you know, they don't make beats for other people for the most part. I know Kanye kind of does, but, like, Tyler doesn't really make beats for other people. He kind of just makes them for himself. Mm-hmm. And so that's why you're seeing, like, Youngboy have to be successful on his beats. You know, he makes a lot of his contemporaries better.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they get to surround himself with Tyler's kind of beats, which he doesn't let other people usually be on.
That's true. There is a handful of, like, you can definitely count them like one hand, the producers, not necessarily the artists, but the producers who are like really driving what a lot of people are listening to.
Like, and there are some good producers, like, you know, you have like Pierre Bourne's a good producer,
yeah,
but I think, you know,
I would say he's a lot one of, yeah, like Metro Boomin
a lot of
as well.
Producers beats, yeah, are one dimensional, right? Like they're for a specific artist. Like a lot of Uzi's producers create like a lot of like space like beats, or like, you know, like Eternal Take kind of beats.
Yeah,
like
Uzi's,
is this
type
kind of like what he's known for and what these producers do, because a lot of them don't really get a chance to, like, you know, to explore and like try new sounds. Like they need money and they need a job, so, you know, they stick to whatever artists they're working for, and they don't really change it up that much.
I think a really the next like big highlight on this song was Lil Wayne. He really came out of nowhere for me, and it was like, first, like halfway in, I was like, wow, Tyler's getting like kind of carried here on his own album, because we've seen like 42 Doug doing a pretty good feature, Youngboy on BA blowing it away, and then an amazing job from Lil Wayne there, kind of coming out of nowhere on Hot Wind Blows. What was your reaction to that verse there?
Well, I wouldn't say that Tyler got carried on any of the songs, because
yeah,
you know,
he didn't do a bad job himself.
Every part of that song besides the feature, it's him. It's all his idea. It's all his. It's like he's just like Igor. So he knows what he wants. So the features really are good. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it was Tyler's idea to bring them on, because he wanted a rap feel. So he's like, who can I bring on for a rap feel? And he nailed it. I mean, the features are really well picked. Not even like Tizo Touchdown is a good feature. You know, Domo Genesis is a great feature. Yeah. You know, you had a lot of good ones on there. And then at the end, when it kind of slows down, it also is really nice.
And yeah, would you think it'd be fair to say, kind of like similar to Flower Boy? I mean, I guess you'd kind of say, when we have had, I do believe we've had a fair share of, was it concept album or a storytelling album we had like a massive debate over? Yeah, I think it was storytelling album.
Talking about Flower Boy.
Yeah.
Flower Boy is the concept and Igor is a storytelling album.
Uh huh. And like, yeah, I think we could go back. I probably actually wouldn't delete one of those episodes, but yeah, like for Call Me If You Get Lost, do you think that fits in the trend of Flower Boy and Igor in kind of a coherent collection of songs, like in a specific narrative? Because I think it's a little bit less so, but I mean, maybe
I don't.
It's definitely not as tight as something like Igor, where it's like the song titles match up. Like, what's your read on that?
You know, I think this one's, I think, a little less clear than Igor was, because Igor was clearly one story being told throughout the entire record. And Flower Boy is a lot of themes, not a lot of stories. And I think it's hard, because I don't know if there are a lot of you know, of course, in stories there are themes, but there is there's a clear story being told. It's not in every song. I think if you just if you go to the lit, like I can name you the songs. All right, you have What's Your Name, Sweet, Wilshire, and maybe Safari. Half of it is really like the album for the most part is. I think a little bit of a self-reflection on his music and on him as a person. Mm-hmm. And he also talked, I think also with it is the story that he's telling as well.
You're saying it's kind of autobiographical a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Where he's kind of like, he reflects on Cherry Bomb and some of his music and kind of his career. But also he tells this really hauntingly beautiful story about how he got comfortable in a shitty situation, and I just think there's a little bit of both there. Like, it's some concepts, some themes he's trying to explore, with not only about the story but about himself. And then there's a story he's telling throughout the album about.
Are you referring to it's kind of like an individual story there on Wiltshire.
Yeah, about like falling in love with the wrong person.
Yeah, I think that, like, to me, yeah, you really get blown away any questions of being carried. On this album, Tyler the Creator, if he's getting carried, those questions are blown away when it comes to Wiltshire, where he pretty much puts together, I would argue, something on the par peer of Duckworth on Damn by Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
Favorite song on that album.
I think Wiltshire and, Sweet and I Thought You Wanted to Dance are two of his best songs he's probably ever written.
I agree with that. Yeah, and he said Sweet was his favorite, actually, and I do
tend to agree. I saw that on Twitter. But I think, it's hard to, question why, because it's a 9-minute song. It was like, okay, wow, this is going to be terrible, and it's, amazing.
The double songs are always great.
I know, but, some people have hesitation when it comes to, a 9-minute mm-hmm. song.
And you got Brent Faiyaz, it's going to be beautiful.
It caught Igor vibes, I think, is what a lot of people are happy with, because
I would say
up in that point that we weren't going to get any Igor vibes. It was just going to be all rap. And, while I personally would have wished for more Igor vibes and more songs that sounded like
Me
Sweet,
too. Yeah,
I'm happy I got that song because it's so good. And Wiltshire is more of just a talking song, which is, isn't probably great if you want to just listen to Igor and just have a good time. But, it's still a great song. It's still, the storytelling is still amazing.
I feel like you almost have to get ready for it to come back to it and be like, okay, I'm going to listen to this and appreciate every single word that's being said.
Yeah. I mean, you can vibe to it a little bit, but I think you're only going to really appreciate it as if you're listening to it.
You get double the worth out of it, I think, if you actually go in for it and you're really you're focused, you're in, you're like, wow. And appreciating what's going on. But I thought, the Brent Faiyaz aspect of that, I can't see who the other name was. Yeah, Faha something. It's right. Cut off on Spotify.
Fana
Hughes, yeah.
Like on a manifesto, he talks about Black Lives Matter
civil rights, and,
civil rights. I think, it's interesting that, he made fun of it, but then he tackles it in his own way. And I think, it just kind of, it's like what Tyler would do is, deal with the situation himself, because it's not about, also how to react to this, but it's also about how, as someone who's a figure to some people, as a famous person, how to react to these kind of things.
It's very unorthodox, because you see a lot of celebrities being very pressured to be, I will never go against the way Black Lives Matter is. It's a very kind of forcing thing to do if you're a celebrity, but Tyler, and true Tyler fashion, is gonna be like, no, I'm gonna say whatever I want, I'm gonna say how I feel, and then giving all his reasons to do so.
Right. But this album is gonna be great. In the summer, it's a fun summertime album,
Yes.
It just seems like it's a good time. And then Sweet and I Thought You Wanted to Dance. I wish we got more of that. I'm hoping there's more of that to come in Tyler's future, 2 years from now when he drops another album. But I think the biggest thing, this is probably just a nitpick about the album, is that he teased this song. It's called, the fans were calling it Numbers, Numbers, Numbers or something. It was a 5-second clip, maybe 10 seconds. and it sounded so Igor and so amazing. And I was so excited to hear the song. I can just play it for a second. It's a snippet, so it's like 2 seconds long. It sounds so good, and I was so excited to hear it. And
yeah, I was really hoping for more Igor stuff. Like that's kind of why I was a little bit disappointed. More Igor, more Flower Boy kind of vein. But
all right, here we go. Yeah. All right, so this is it. People are calling it numbers. I don't know what people want to call it, but it's from the voicemails when you would call. Here we go.
Yes, I remember that.
That's
Yeah. It's very jingly. It's very good. Yeah, I see what you mean.
It sounds like 911. You know, I really wish we got that song because it just sounds so good, but we didn't, and it's okay.
Yeah, I think that sounds like something he like threw together in 2 seconds. I feel like that's so easy. What I was really hoping, I didn't really expect it to happen, but there was a clip on his Instagram that was like. Maybe like right as the pandemic struck in like March, where he's like in this like keyboard room and there's like a big
yeah, I saw that. That was nice.
And that beat there, I was hoping that was incorporated into like the album in some way. That is just the best beat. It's not even a beat. It's like, you know, it's like a song in and of itself.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of songs he made that sound like Igor after Igor. Like, I'm sure he made a bunch of
about putting on the album and didn't.
I think once he decided he wanted to do a Gangsta Grills tape, he kind of threw that to the side.
Yeah. And he's been rapping for a pretty long time, for quite a few years.
I mean, he's been in the game as long as Drake has been in the game. Like, that's how long he's been making music.
And they've had completely, diverging careers now. And they represent, I don't know. They do not have very... kind of similar fan bases, shall we say.
Well, Drake...
They don't have many people in common, so they're two kind of polar opposites of, like, the culture of, like, well, like mainstream versus kind of, like, out there, you know, or at least, quote-unquote, out
there. Right, but Drake has kind of, like, blown up, and then he just kind of stayed big, and he changes his stuff a little bit, you know, he like a little dance hall.
He changes his which culture he wants to appropriate every few years.
Exactly. But, like, he changed, like, a little bit, but for the most part, it's Drake. It stays the same. Drake's Drake. But I think... You know, he talks about in his own songs that, like, he matured. You know, I think Tyler said in one of his songs, like, I hit puberty at 23, which is not, like, a reference to actual puberty. It's reference to his maturity in music.
Was that when he dropped Flower Boy or something?
I'm not sure, but I think, you know, the point of what he's saying is, like, he started with Goblin or Young, was it Goblin?
Bastard.
You're right, it was Bastard. Start with Bastard, and then, you know, it's like rap hard, you know, offending people, not giving a fuck. And then it became like Wolf, which is like rapping, not really as like hard as it used to be with like Odd Future. And then it became Cherry Bomb, which was like insanely aggressive back to his old ways.
Also, there was a lot of melodic stuff kind of coming through there.
Right. But then Flower Boy came out, and it's like, whoa, what the fuck is this? And then people liked it. They loved it. I mean...
Yeah, that was kind of a crossing the Rubicon moment.
It's a great album. And then he dropped Igor, and everyone's like, holy fuck, this guy is changing it up, and it's amazing. It's awesome. And then some people were like, I don't know. I like the old Tyler. I'm not really a big fan of this stuff.
Yeah, it's definitely polarizing for...
Maturity, it's just crazy. Like, you don't see that kind of maturity, or that kind of at least change. Maybe you don't think it's maturity, but... that an artist can go through, like you can see it by the albums, and like now it just feels like he's doing this rap stuff, but it's way more calculated, and it's way more like he's doing it on purpose, and we get it.
I would say this is a kind of combination of a lot of the sounds that he's used to great success over the years. Like, you could say each one kind of similar to, like, you know, maybe one's like more of a Cherry Bomb, a lot of Wolf and Goblin, and like early kind of influences there in terms of like very brash and aggressive production.
I would agree. I think that's really accurate and just amazing. I'm it's just crazy that he hit it again. You know, like, in my opinion, he's gone 1, 2, 3. I mean, these albums, yeah. He's not.
I would agree. 100% agree with that.
He's not in a bad album since 2015. So I think he's on a roll. And I don't know where I can now officially say I have no idea where he's going to go with this album. They don't even have a little bit of an idea after this. But I think he's earned the right for everyone to be excited and be ready.
What was your favorite song on this album?
You know, I know a lot of people are going to say Sweet, and I think I just have to agree with them because it just – I loved Igor so much. You know, my friend introduced me. I didn't even listen to Tyler until Igor. So, like, he showed me Igor. I didn't even like Igor at first. Then I
– Me neither. I kind of went – started with Flower Boy, then worked into Igor a little bit.
Then I listened to Flower Boy. Then I love Flower Boy. Now I really like this. Mm-hmm. So I think I just think a lot of it is really good. So I love, you know, since I started with Igor, I think I'm a little biased when it comes to if I hear Sweet, I Thought You Wanted to Dance is kind of Igor vibes. And so I really like it. But I also love Corso. What's Your Name?
Me too.
Rise is good. Juggernaut's good.
Yeah, Juggernaut was what I was going to say. It was another stellar 3 out of 3 song on this album plus. And Wiltshire, of course, was on par with
I love the Lemonhead production, but I'm not the biggest fan of the Forward to Doug feature. So
I was going to say that too.
That's why it's not my favorite song, but I love the production throughout the entire album. I think they're all really good. I mean, I love them all. Run It Up's really good too. I think a lot of them are just pretty amazing. And then I just think Sweet and I Thought You Wanted to Dance is just better than all of the songs.
Yeah, Hot Wind Blows is very, very good as well. The Lil Wayne verse, it kind of comes out of nowhere. That was the most probably encouraging moment. It was I got to be honest, it was a little bit lackluster, as I said before, after Sir Baudelaire. You know, not to go too hard on it, but after that, I was this is I think it's still stayed to be one of the best songs on the album. There's some good bars all the way around from Tyler the Creator, and it shows you he has to be probably the one of the most versatile, talented artists that we have today, because very few people could do that. The two main things on that things he says that he's most proud of on that album is all songs written and produced and arranged by Tyler. So that shows you how much creative independence and how much leverage he has in the cold world that is the music industry.
Yeah, I mean, it was amazing. I loved listening to it. The album was great. The songs are amazing. And I just wish there was more.
Yeah, I really hope we do get some more good albums soon. Have you heard about any new music that's in the future?
Yeah, well, we got... I know Uzi's dropping a project this year sometime. I've heard good things.
That's 4 years from now.
Yeah, maybe. I think he's going to drop it this year, though. Yeah. I mean, and people apparently said that someone heard it and said it's amazing. Some guy. And then they talked about it in the Joe Budden podcast I listened to.
Interesting.
And then Drake, of course. But who knows? We get from Drake. Scorpion was okay. And then who else? Everyone in the world has been hearing about a Kendrick album coming. Who knows if that's coming?
Yes, I think that could blow Tyler out of the water, but it would be very, very good to see.
I think the one album that
we need a new Kendrick album so badly.
The one album that could maybe stop Tyler from maybe winning a Grammy. I don't know. I mean, I think right now Tyler's the album of the year. I mean, I know it's early. I just think
pole position for sure. Insane year, to be quite honest.
And this time he'll deserve the best rap album.
Yeah. It was very ironic last time that he ended up winning.
But I think a Frank album could maybe dethrone him or something
Yeah. That was another, there's so many great wrinkles in this album, and we'll get to more Tyler the Creator music in just a few minutes here. So if you've been listening through our talk and want to hear some music, stay tuned with us here for just a few minutes. But the fact that we saw Frank Ocean coming in on that the end of Lemonhead, I believe it was, or what's your name, was so I was ooh, is that who I think it is? It was very, very exciting, and it speaks this kind of weird mental battle internal mental battle that like hardcore fans of Frank Ocean I see are like locked into, which is like, because many people speculate that he's just like taking a break, staying out of music because his brother died and he was like very torn up about that. That is the kind of like speculation on like Frank Ocean Reddit and stuff like that. And there's this really kind of weird dynamic that's like, Frank, take your time, take all the time you need, and acting like they're not like totally obsessed and like devastated and want to like come back as soon as possible. Like, they're like, oh, Frank, take all the time you need, but like, I would love a new album, and if you don't, like, I may like kill myself or something. They're so like over dramatic about it, but the fact that he showed up there was very, very encouraging. I like Frank Ocean album like in September or something, coming like right into the fall, because most albums you wanted to come out like right now as we get into the summer, but Frank Ocean, you want him to come out when you get into the fall. That is the peak Frank Ocean season, in my opinion. But
right.
Yeah. Are you a Frank Ocean fan?
I haven't listened to all of his stuff, but I should, because I'm an idiot.
Yeah. I started to listen to Endless, which is his album that much maligned, not maligned, but like he released it as a secondary album to get out of a record deal.
Yeah. I heard of it.
Yeah. Again, that's an incredible story. I think we've talked about that on the old Uncle Shit at least, but he gets out of that record deal, and a lot of people say that that album, for example, I know Anthony Fantano was like talking about this, like, oh, Endless is one of the best Frank Ocean albums, like people need to like learn how to go on SoundCloud or whatever. But yeah, I think that's something worth getting into. That's my music to-do list. But anyway, What album are you most personally looking forward to?
Personally, I was really excited for this album. I've become a huge Tyler fan like the past 3-4 years. So, I don't know. I guess now I'd be looking forward to the Uzi album. We didn't mention Travis at all. Travis.
If he picks up a, like, he's been in a bit of a slump lately, I would say. But if he gets passing through that. That would be, I definitely think he can. I think his music's been kind of getting better and better from the post-Astroworld slump that he was in. I think that's definitely a fair thing to say. But I think he could get back and produce a pretty cool project.
I agree.
All right. You're going to say?
I was going to say, like, you know, I hope the album's great. I give it a 10 out of 10, personally. So, you know, I know you are going to listen to some more music with your fans.
Yes. We're going to get right into that. Thank you so much, Hunter, for joining us. And I'm sure we'll see you by.
Of course. I'll be back.
Yeah, that'll be great. All right. Thank you very much for joining us. That's Hudson Alexander on Uncultured. We're going to get right into it. We're not going to waste any time. We got a new album to play. We're starting with the 42 Doug Lemonhead. Y'all niggas know Sound Culture. You say pandemic? Yo. Oh, you want to see a pandemic? Really hot. This shit remove us from the game. This shit really get crazy.
I don't lean, but my house do. Off the hill with the mean view. Nice house, if you look out, you can see some eagles and a few yachts. Got a roommate, he won't move out. If he won't smoke, he the cool out. And he drill shit, got the two out. It's the Wolf Gang, Brooklyn Zoo out. Nigga, Wu-Tang, you get chewed out. Then we woo out. It's a split mode, and they know you push it like the douche out. Bitch, I'm cool, and his mouth wet. He a poo now. Used to stage die, but they sue now. I was too hot. TLC waterfalls on my chest, help me cool out. Got 2-minute calls, should've go call. They catching dust, won't even stall. Illo with lemon heads looking like ball. Keep your protect, I spent that on all. How much it cost? Shit, I don't know. But I know that stage a million is show. Stuck in my ways, they say how so. First nigga put a bike rack on the rolls.
Young turn nigga, I be fucking these hoes. 20 appearance, I get it, I go. Rich to the world, come see me, I love. I ain't rockin' with cuz, nigga, free my bros. I ain't got no safe, nigga, see me shining. Still fuck, I'm grinding. 84 grand remand. 2-ton pack in this bitch. God damn it. 10 bad hoes, nigga, look at that bitch. This selling dope, I be cooking that shit. No hoodie like 6 bands. Over 100. I'm finna buy them, bitch. We get money. Might tip a good hoe, but nigga, she ain't getting none. Cargo skirt. Hold on. Nigga, you got lucky. All this paper, I can bet she fuck. I ain't doing no tucking. I ain't doing no saving. Took it from a lame, I get this bitch back. No, I ain't crazy. Still so straight. Like, get on, bitch. Just spit on shit, man. Oh, my God.
Rippler. Yeah, he got dropped. I'm gone. We gone. We gone.
My bro is running his finger around the I Wei Wei, I Vey Vey bowl. I got that shit sitting on my kind of like a fruit bowl that's like 100 racks. I like the color green in every shade. I like life. Mine. Like my life. Don't fucking bite. Y'all niggas love to steal.
You look malnourished. Let's get some bread, fried an egg. Yo, you're drowning in syrup. You can spot, you can tell. You could be tourists. Let's go to Cannes and watch a couple indie movies that you never heard of. Listen to bands, move when we dance. Disco in France, smell some perfume, head in the wind. We can switch off, I can show you how you can really exfoliate skin. If you got a man, you should cut it off. Get your passport, cause we run it off. We can sit and talk. You can tell me everything that's on your chest, baby. Get it off. You want your name?
Yeah. What is your name? What do you bring? Yeah. I think that I got what you need and I'm willing to do anything that you please. I'm sorry, I couldn't have changed. My clan like Sonic can't speak, no. No, you can't hit my lean, no. Baby, tell me where the peace go. Cause I'm lost. Your body compared to the fashion. I hope you ain't got in the shit that I bought. Cause money ain't don't mean a thing. I bet you the times that I take you out. 1 minute, it's a beautiful scene. And it probably end when we been took out.
What's your name, girlfriend? What's your name? 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 Yeah.
Pull up, black boy, hop out. Shout out to my mother and my father. Didn't...
Hold up!
Oh my
God, hold up! Ladies and gentlemen,
is that Lil Wayne verse we were telling you so much about? Yeah, we'll get to it in a second. It's Hot Wind Blows.
We on the yacht. A young lady just fed me French vanilla ice cream. We all got our toes out too. Call me when you get lost.
I'm a travel the globe, you keep the block hot driver. Open the door for me, my hair hurt, find us. We playing hide and seek with the passports. Where the fuck we at? Oh, the pilot gotta remind us, yeah. The luggage is piling, I need a clothes to wear. So many stinky sit in my wallet, look like a folding chair. The Cartier so light on my body, thought I floated here. We boated here, it's Tunchi and Tyler, but call me Baudelaire, yeah. Out in Switzerland, travel with my bitch, she gave me kissing dog. I love when she let me rub her like Michelin. 100 grand to sleep on the bird, the wings are whistling like... Man, they ain't listening. We cross the line like immigrants and benefit from it. Keep on stunting on these niggas, make them sick to their stomach, man. Y'all don't understand. Fish so fresh that you can taste the same. Yeah, we getting lost, but we know who we can. Bada, sun, sun, sun. Treat that last part like you niggas ain't saying nothing. Yeah.
You see these excursions right here? Just too lavish to post on the gram.
Gangsta, greasy.
Excuse me, you are listening to Culture.
The wind is so hard to me like Mother Nature arguing about some baby father beeping. I'm stuck in the middle of the sandwich like slaughter me. Got my middle fingers to the cameras, that's recording me from y'all to me. Brrr. Stop calling me unless you're ordering. I'm on the beach, I got my feet out. And I stay on my feet, the corner beat, I'm on a deep route. Just throw the ball at me, thought all this lean would have me see now. I guess they see now, that's touchdown. Catch a beat down like I catch touchdowns. I fuck round and slow the beat down and take the drums out. The speed of my blood, I'm so greedy, I'ma eat my own flow. And I'm in need of a flaw, I'ma eat me a rapper, I might as well eat me a hoe.
Oh.
I'm hot as hell when the weather is freezing and cold. As a devil, a demon, and ghost. I'ma get even some more. It's too late to even get low. Bye, whoop gang, that's what I need you to know. Moonlight, Weezy the goat. The wind beneath my wings, desert eagle underneath my coat. Yeah. Moolah, bitch.
Hard wind.
You are listening to Uncultured.
Keep it locked right now. We're celebrating that special song you know and love. hitting a billion streams, a billy on Spotify.
You are listening to Uncultured.
I'm a venereal disease, like a menstrual bleed through the pencil and leak on the sheet of the tablet in my mind. Cause I don't write shit, cause I ain't got time. Cut my seconds, minutes, hours, go to the almighty dollar and the almighty power of that chopper. Sister, brother, son, daughter, father, motherfucker, copper. Got the Maserati dancing on the bridge, pussy popping, tell the coppers. Ha 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 ha, you can't catch them, you can't stop them. I go by them goon rules. If you can't beat them, then you pop them. You can't man them, then you mop them. You can't stand them, then you drop them. You pop them, cause we pop them like over red and vodka. Motherfucker, I'm ill. Yeah. A million here, a million there. Sicilian bitch with long hair, with coconut every year. Like smoking a thing is here. I open the Lamborghini, hoping them crackers see me. Like, look at that bastard Weezy. He's a beast, he's a dog, he's a motherfucking problem. Okay, you're a goon, but what's a goon to a gobbler? Nothing, nothing. You ain't scaring nothing. On some faggot bullshit, call him Dennis Rodman. Call me with your own peach, call me on my sidekick. Never answer when it's private. Damn, I hate a shy bitch. Don't you hate a shy bitch? Yeah, I hate a shy bitch. She ain't shy no more, she changed her name to my bitch. Yeah, nigga, that's my bitch. So when she asks for the money, when you through, don't be surprised, bitch. And it ain't trickin' if you got it. But you like a bitch with no ass, you ain't got shit. Motherfucker, I'm ill, not sick. And I'm okay, but my watch sick. Yeah, my drop sick. Yeah, my Glock sick. Am I not thick? I'm ill. Motherfucker, I'm ill. Yeah. See, they say I'm rapping like Big J and Tupac. Andre 3000, where is Erica Badu at? Who that say they gon' be Lil Wayne? My name ain't big, but I keep that flame. Like, who that wanna do that? Boy, you knew that you that swallow. And I be this shit, now you got loose bowels. I don't owe you like 2 hours, but I would like for you to pay me by the hour. And I'd rather be pushing flowers than to be in the pen sharing showers. Tony told us this world was ours, and the Bible told us every girl was sour. Don't flee in a garden and don't smell her flower. Call me Mr. Carter or Mr. Lawnmower. Boy, I got so many bitches like I'm Mike Lowry. Even Gwen Stefani said she couldn't doubt me. Motherfucker, I say life ain't shit without me. Chrome lips poking out the coop, look like it's pouting. I do what I do and you do what you can do about it. Bitch, I'll turn a crack rock into a mountain. Damn, man, don't you compare me, cause there ain't nobody near me. They don't see me, but they hear me.
We're giving that promise of the new Tyler the Creator album. Call Me If You Get Lost coming your way. It's Juggernaut, Tyler, Lil Uzi Vert, and Pharrell on this one. It's hot. It's on Uncultured. Keep listening.
I just cut some fresh lemons. Where's the sugar? Lemon in my A, lemon in my L's. Call them boogers. Rather 6 feet before I'm ever seen with you niggas.
Hold up. Hold up.
Yo. What it is? It's that nigga T. Still a color game. The floor, that's Giano's shoe. What I'm running in, earlobe, look like headlights. I'm a freezing, I'm some motherfucking dead ass. I need some Timberlands. I battle any man. Yo, but don't think they understand.
She wanna kick it with me, she back, eat it and leave. She try to save other plants, but keep eating my meat. We can't see none of them grow, she keep eating my seed. Got an E and a B on the back of the CT. I'm done with the 12, got a V16. Say the money coming in, yeah, that's true. The more money I get, I don't want sex you. Can't think about the last time that I text you. It's probably when sidekicks had them belt loops. Sign my giant hand, cock on a bitch, every time I check you. Just like a brand new lamb, I wreck you. So if it's mine, it's yours.
Ride to the dinner table. I'm a damn in the mad in the exit. Master more than what Google say my net is. I got chatter with the shads in it to the exit.
This is
double P, I rock double C. Man, I run in beats like you run in cleats. Man, come to me, you want sun to see. This eternity flawless, a double V's. What troubles me is you couple me with these subtle fleas trying to double D. Hornet, trucking a hive of a motherfucking bumblebee. They just got the closest picture of the fucking sun surface. That was us. Got the life of Rami, part that bitch just for one purpose. Catching dust. My secret service carry mobs, you call them street sweepers. Back you up, tat you up, then add you up, then give you a cover like Adjua. If the shit's fake, I don't respect it, it's clickbait. And that's this taste like a shit shake. What a difference your wrist make when it's Richard made. Hungry eyes tend to fixate like an empty stomach for a fish plate. Shit face, get this straight. This is truck wheel deck grip tape.
Ride to the tape.
Cause she's sucking his dick. Why it's so slut like we slimy and slick? Got a young bullet, pull it, let it spin. He hit it, no miss. Hop out a jet, hop in the rose. Pacey Patek, straight off the show. I want the platinum, I'm cool on the gold. She sucking his dick, stop the riding on. I follow O'Callis, I said it on fold. I pop me a pill, I forget that for sure. You front me a pack, I'ma go get it sold. You wanna, you wanna, I
it's Unculture for all the latest hip-hop and hottest rap all summer long. Every Saturday night.
I cannot breathe cause there's ice on my gills. She give me brain as that earth on chill. She makes a white, told on my name Jalil. Uzi too rich, man, how does it feel? Trying to be humble, man, I ain't trying to kill. They walk on my heels made of steel. That's no oil, my spill, I burnt off the wheel. She ate up the deal, my baby so spoiled. Just like some oatmeal, the paint on my whip, it's already peeled. Put my dick in her gut, it's just for the guilt. Fuck any bitch, did that right on film. I need the beat, that's just for the stems.
Yeah. Strawberry peels, 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 strawberry peels.
The waterfall is crazy.
It's sweet.
Tell him something.
Slash, I thought you wanted to dance. The famous 10th song on Call Me If You Get Lost.
We fell in love. I read the signs.
You are listening to Uncultured.
أنت تستمع إلى غير مثقفين.
That's all about the time we have for you today. This has been Uncultured. We're closing out with a little bit of Missy Elliott and Pharrell Williams. Remember, we are back every Saturday all summer long for the hottest rap and hip-hop in the game and the latest news about the culture. My name is Spence Wells. Thank you so much for listening. Spence Wells Radio Network. Speak your live event. Head to the flow, don't collect that dough. You better huddle up, cause the beat's so cold.